this is the next speaker, is the imam from Frenchwood, Maulana Sayyid Ahmed.
Takbir!
Allah!
Takbir!
Allah!
Takbir!
Allah!
Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salamu ala ibadihi alladhina istafa. Amma ba'd. Respected brothers, elders, fathers, colleagues. Today we are gathered because even the one with the weakest iman of us cannot be but moved by the plight of our brothers and sisters in Palestine and also in the West Bank Gaza Strip. Brothers and sisters, I don't need to say anything more on the situation itself, but I would just like to give one of my own thoughts as an observation, that we think or we talk about the timing. The timing is that Israeli elections are coming. I personally, actually a couple of months ago, I was thinking that when a dog loses his master, he starts worrying about his next meal. The credit crisis, especially in America, has completely or on the verge of destroying America. Now Israel is seeing that its master is dying. Its master is no longer capable of giving it 10 billion plus every year loans free of interest. I personally believe that this is to show the Arabs that don't think because we've lost our master or we are losing our master or we're losing our financial backing that we are, this is just a show. Unfortunately, for them, killing a couple of hundred or a couple of thousand people because the rest, water, that was destroyed when Hamas came in. Electricity, that was destroyed when Hamas came in. All the rest, it's happened already in the last two years or even before Hamas came in. Constant control of the borders, not letting anything through, no oil. How many times did we hear that the hospitals are suffering because there is no oil to run the services, the gas stations? So for us now, we have to, as Muslims, and especially Muslims, only thing or the best thing we can do is to pray. At the same time, let's start doing something writing. I can't watch the TV, I can't watch the news. 5 minutes of BBC or ever coverage, I switch it off. I can't stand the language. Let's write, tell them that your language is biased. The BBC will act. Russell Brand talks rubbish, they act. They have a few presenters who they don't like, people start complaining, 5, 10 complaints, couple of hundred complaints, they act. What we have to do is, before we work internationally, let's work on the people that we can do something about. Write to them, email them, and tell them, point out to them where we feel that the language and the bias reporting is coming from. If they get a couple of hundred, couple of thousand complaints, then they will change. Because recently, we had an engaged program, and they mentioned an incident where some British MPs, they went to Palestine. In the West Bank, they were stoned by the settlers. Originally, the BBC put it on their website, British MPs stoned in Palestine, in the West Bank. They made a complaint that this does not show the true picture. And they threatened to take the BBC to court for using wrong language. Straight away, the BBC were forced to write, British MPs attacked and stoned by Israeli settlers. The least we can do is to make sure that the reporting, the bias that we find in the reports, at least let the victims show the true picture, let the victims, their cries be heard in the right way, where the world can take notice. So I pray that we will. Next week, we will gather here. Hopefully, majority, if not all of us, will be making plans to go to London next week. Write to your MPs, but the least we can do is to complain to these organizations about the language they use. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the true understanding and to do what is best for him, for his prophet, and for the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.